You've seen our next guest as Tiffany Pensatucky Dodgett on Netflix hit show Orange is the New Black. And now she's starring in a new suspense thriller that is tackling social issues head on. Please welcome Taryn Manning.
I love this pantsuit.
Me
too. You.
So good.
Thank you.
We're so happy to have you. Now, your breakout role was Nola in the movie Hustle and Flow. You were so young. Tell me about that experience.
Oh my, yes, I was young. That was really fun. It was so great working with Terrence Howard and Taraji and Elise Neal and Anthony Anderson. And I knew at the table read, which sometimes can be really flat, you know, you're just reading it out loud, but this time, everyone was, I mean, there was like crying and fighting. Like the movie just came to life right there. John Singleton was like filming the whole thing and just the energy. And I was like, wow, so young and just excited. And we were in Memphis and I had braids like down to here.
Yeah, I remember.
They did my hair up. So yeah, it was fun.
That's so cool.
Yeah, of course we know that you played Pensatucky in Orange is the New Black. At that time, or even now, how important was it to you to address women's issues in the criminal justice system?
You know, at the time, I didn't, you know, we learn as we go, and I didn't know so much of the inner workings of the system as I do now, you know, just the privatization of prison, the infrastructure, you know, it's a beast. And it's a system, and you know, you can get caught up in it, and it's sad. And we did a lot of charity work for women that, you know, like we're all one kind of crime or bad day away from seeing red and going somewhere forever. So a lot of these women, they just made one mistake that like changed their life. So it was really fun to like reform them. And there's a program where they get like nice business clothes and they go out to find their first jobs, and just their happiness when we'd help them was like worth everything.
Yeah.
So yeah.
They've been through a lot. Imagine.
Yeah.
Yeah, that's great.
It's not fun in prison, you know. Sometimes the show made it seem, to me, it seemed like a good time, but that's the entertainment aspect of it, you
of
know?
Course.
Otherwise, no. No thanks.
Absolutely not.
Yeah.
So let's talk about your new movie. It's a controversial thriller called Karen. hello, tell us about that. I think the name is awesome.
Woo! Yeah, so that's, you know, there's a term that goes around, and it's called a Karen, and typically she's defined by, you know, she's entitled, racist, very prejudiced, and just a miserable person, you know, through and through. So, yeah, I went ahead and took the offer. It was a leading role and everything, and I was excited because as an actor, you know, I love my craft and I love what I do, but I was so conflicted about it. The film, yeah, I was. And, just because it's so active at this time and I never wanted people to feel like I was oxygenating something that does not need any more like fuel.
Yeah.
But at the same time, sometimes we have to face things head on to see change and to really illuminate, you know, these types of people that can, you know, destroy people's lives with one phone call.
But you face some backlash with some white women because you're playing Karen. How did you deal with that and the negativity of it all?
Oh my goodness, I still am. But you know, I was shocked, but at the same time, I was disappointed in myself because I didn't think about everybody. You know, I really was sort of one side on, you know, trying to do my part as a white woman that has no right to even speak on something I'll never ever understand fully. Yeah. I never thought about the opposite side of that, and so one, it was very hard, and I, you know, because they all made sense, but at the same time, the way they hit me up and it's all in the approach, right?
Right.
Very like, and then I would you know, I was very like grappling with do I respond back with kindness or go, oh yeah, you know what I mean? Or do I fight fire with fire? But I realized that, you know, if you kill people with kindness, like some of these trolls or Karens, if you will, they just want attention.
Yeah.
And the minute you go, I'm so sorry, you know, I didn't mean to personally offend you, which is also what I've been dealing with all around. They mostly say, well, I never thought you'd respond or, you know, but I just
want people. Exactly, and then it turns. Mm-hmm. But you like know what, as an actress, you take on a role and it's not like, you're not doing it for society. You're doing it as your art and what you're doing as a job, right?
I mean, not this particular time. This particular time, I became very close with the director, who's a man of color, and we're very tight, and he knows my heart, he knows me, and it was just trying to do my part to help, illuminate some of that.
It affected your personal life.
Right.
Yeah, but it's okay. It's all right.
That's great.
Well, we have a clip of you from Karen, so let's check it out, because I want to see it.
Nice to meet you. I'm Malik.
Oh, I don't shake. I'm a bit of a germaphobe.
Yeah, okay.
Well, just wanted to come over and introduce myself.
I appreciate that. I see you take home security very seriously.
Well, what would make you say that?
You know, I saw all the cameras around your house and whatnot, and
so you've been looking at my house?
No. I mean, I just so happen to see you have so
you're
many.
You're casing the joint.
Casing?
We don't have any cash.
Excuse me?
Oh.
Jeez. Oh. Oh. That feels heavy. And shout out to Tia's husband, Corey. That was a piece,
yes,
too. Oh, my God. Congratulations, you guys both working together.
Yes.
Thank you so much for stopping by and hanging out with us and breaking down exactly what that film meant to you.
Yes.
Karen is now available on video on demand and all digital platforms, including Apple, Amazon, and everywhere movies are sold.